Yet again in America. Yet again in America, innocent families are slumped to their knees in grief, living the agonizing and unimaginable wait to retrieve the bullet-riddled bodies of their children and parents slaughtered in senseless gun violence. Yet again in America, we search our souls for answers, beg our leaders for solutions that thus far have not come. By one broad measure, the 251st mass shooting in our homeland this year happened 13 hours after the 250th, yet again in America. And uniquely American, this happens with regularity in large numbers as a pattern just here, nowhere else. Granted, mass shootings like the ones in El Paso and in Dayton represent only a small fraction of our nation's gun violence. But attacks like these are all the more traumatizing, perhaps because after the fact, we can all put ourselves there. We can picture ourselves at a crowded Walmart on tax-free day, scooping up school supplies as kids run about the crowded aisles. We can relate to being at a bar late on a summer Saturday, having a conversation and a laugh with some friends. And now we know what it looks like and sounds like when the regular stops along our journeys in an instant deliver a turning point in our lives or end them. Yet again in America. So much of the everyday must-dos are now at least occasionally clouded in fear, like sending our kids to school. Columbine, Little Rock, Pearl, Parkland, Newtown, University of Texas, Virginia Tech. Fear of gun violence. At work, at a stadium, a movie theater, a house of worship, a Walmart, a bar. As for details on 250, a young man complained online about what he called a Hispanic invasion of Texas. Familiar language. Cops say he drove hundreds of miles from home to that Walmart along the Mexico border, to a store known to attract Mexican families looking for products that they can't get across the line. It was particularly busy on the morning he chose, the school shopping and all, the preparing for kids' futures. Manifesto. Invasion. He killed them. Say police, he's talking in jail and has no regrets. Yet again in America. Then as the long day and night rolled into the wee hours, as bodies still lay where they dropped at the Walmart after the bullets ripped the life from their bodies, 251. Another angry young man pulled the trigger on his rifle many states away outside a bar. Within 30 seconds, police say 9 people were dead, dozens hurt, hundreds traumatized. Cops in Dayton have not yet explained the shooter's motive, but the killer's former classmates say he'd once been kicked out of school for making a list of girls he wanted to kill. One woman says the gunman once confessed to her that he fantasized about trying to slit her throat and tying her up. Of mass shooting number 251, she says, "This isn't a mystery to me." Is this shocking to you, debilitating or unimaginable? Or is it one of those things that happens yet again in America? Sadly, routine. After all, the Gilroy Garlic Festival was just last week. Remember that? Remember the details of that one? They do in Gilroy. Or Las Vegas. Or the Pulse Nightclub. The synagogue in Pittsburgh, the Sikh temple in Wisconsin, the Baptist church in Texas, the Bible study in Charleston. You remember something of many, maybe, as a cable news viewer, likely not all 251 just this year. But survivors will tell you, you never forget. If you saw the killer up close, smelled the blood when it was over, or buried your child, you can't forget, ever. Each time we hear kids cry, parents pray, and politicians promise, then it happens yet again in America. Here, a friend mourning the teacher in El Paso who was buying classroom supplies but didn't survive. Here, sisters holding each other in Dayton near the spot where their brother drew his last breath. They'll remember. Now, gun laws, regulations, background checks, soft targets, body armor, death penalty, mental health, time for action, I promise, thoughts and prayers. We hear you. We heard you last time and the time before that. And we'll likely do it all soon, yet again in America.